une pensée d'Arachem à sa femme, à sa mère et au Bénexu.
That Hashem, he gave the Torah in Har Sinai, in the desert.
Yeah.
And the only reason why Hashem, he gave the Torah in the desert, because Hashem, he asking from the Jews effort, amal, and we know only through effort we can produce something. Only through effort we can show how much we love Hashem. HaKadosh Baruch Hu will not send a test to somebody that it is in love. So I know it's very hard. Today the situation in the world, around the world, everywhere. Look what happened to him, this man, this French minister in America.
Yeah, never.
Look what happened to him. Now only Hashem knows what we will know this week or next week if it was true. It was not true, but just look, I would like to be in his place. To catch me and to blame me for things that I didn't do. I mean, it's terrible. He lost everything. He lost everything. I mean, today, can you imagine how high he was? He was on top of the sky. He was so famous, he was so rich, he was supposed to be the next French president. Everybody here in France was afraid from his electoral campaign. And look what happened. Look what happened to him. They accused him for rape, they accused him for something, so a woman to do something. We don't know if it's true or not true. We will know. But let's see if it's not true. Let's see if it's not true. All this damage, all what he had, money, losing money, his covered, his glory, all what he was working for all his life, he lost everything in 1 minute. If it is true, so just imagine how bad a man can be to lose everything in 1 minute. To cause a damage, a figure damage, a damage. And this is the parasha of this week and the parasha of last week. So that's why you have to be strong, you understand? You have to be very, very strong, you understand me?
Yes.
HaKadosh Baruch Hu will, Be'ezrat Hashem, he will not let us down, Be'ezrat Hashem. The parasha of this week, it's Bamidbar. Bamidbar, Naso, the parasha, the parasha of next week. If you see these two parashiyot, the Torah use a lot of calculation. The Torah, they count how many Jews there were in Egypt. I would just ask you one question: what do we need? How many Jews there were? The parasha of Naso is the biggest parasha of all parashiyot, and this parasha just talk. Repetition. The way the 12 tribute, the way they inaugurate the temple, it's so long. Yes or no?
Yes.
And look all this calculation that Torah, the counters, that the Torah count how many Jews there were, how many each tribute it is. I mean, look, a lot of times the Torah, it's so short. When she talk about Shabbat, when the Torah talk about Nida, when the Torah talk about something, and here, I would like to ask you one question, David. What would you feel on Shabbat when you will read all this calculation of the Jews? What matter it to you? How many they were? It doesn't matter how many they were. Did you ask? When you take the plane, do you ask the pilot or the steward how many people there is in the plane?
No.
Yes or no? Huh? No.
No.
No. It doesn't matter to me. What I mean, if you go to a stad, you know, a football stad, would you be interested to know how many there were? No, what do I care? If it's full, if it's half full, it's half full. Why the Torah make this all this countage and the trumpet of Rehoboam, there were the family, how many families there were, and how many people there were, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So what do I need? And special, my question is about women. Why the Torah don't count women? Why? Do you have an answer? The parash of Hukotai, what it is Hukotai, im amil liyut amil li batora, yes or no?
Okay, the law is hard to understand.
I mean, you must be amil, you must put effort.
Strive.
Yes, to study Torah. Because people, they want just to accomplish mitzvot. But the Torah wants something else, something special from you. To give value of the Torah. If you give value of the Torah will give to you the value. When a man die, the first thing they look at his hand, if he has Torah in his hand. Ashrei mi shiba lekan v'talmudu b'yado. What a pleasure for a man after 120 years, when he pass away, when he bring with him Torah and mitzvot. Torah. Not only mitzvot, Torah. Ashrei mi shiba lekan v'talmudu b'yado. When a man gives the value of the Torah in this world, and give from his time to the Torah, so the Torah will give him his value. What it is the value of a man? I would just ask you a question. A king, before he was a king, he was just as a, he was just a citoyen, a citizen, yes or no?
Yes.
He was like everybody. And suddenly he became a king.
Yes.
The difference between before and now, before it was nothing, and now he's a king. Why now he has a value? Because he's the king. He's the head of the state. Look the difference between a poor man and a rich man. A poor man is a poor man. I mean, you will not give him the value. He's not valuable. It's nothing. He's a poor. You know what Shlomo HaMelech said? Hem amdabrim. A man who has money, through his money we talk to him. Not because we like him, because the money that he has in his pocket. Because the money makes the man valuable. Yes or no? The man become valable,
yes.
Because of the money. The king too. There is a difference between a healthy man and a man that is not well. The difference between them, the man that is not well, is not well. He may die any day, but the man that is, would you sign a contract with a man that is going to die? No. Because he's ill, but a man will sign a contract with somebody who is healthy. So b'chukotai, when a man give value to the Torah and he study Torah and he love Torah, so after 120 years, ashrei mi shiba lekan v'talmudu, up there they will give him a big value, a big cover, because he has Torah in his hand. Through the Torah that he has in his hand, they will give him all what he needs up there. Ashrei mi shiba lekan v'talmudu b'yado. Ashrei. I would like to tell you this. The Gemara, there is a story in the Gemara about a man who look at the future. It's Masechet Shabbat, the Gemara Shabbat, page 156.
Okay.
There is a man that he was looking at the future. And that one day, his name is Avlet. He was sitting next to Shmuel. Okay. And they were talking together. And suddenly, a man was passing. And Avlet, he said to Shmuel, "This man is going to die. I see that this man is going to die." Okay?
Yes.
And a few hours later, they saw that man that he did not die. So Shmuel, he said to Avlet, "You told me that this man is going to die, but look, he's alive." So Avlet was so surprised. He went to the man, and he saw the man that he has something in his shoulder. He has something very heavy in his shoulder. He was carrying, some stuff in his shoulder. He took out the stuff from his shoulder and he opened it, and he saw there a snake that he died. A snake. So Avlet, he said to the man, so Shmuel, he said to that man, "Tell me what you did this hour." He said, "This hour I did a mitzvah. I give tzedakah for achnasat kala. I give tzedakah to some people that they want to get married and they had no money to get married. So I give them the money I had in my pocket." So he told him, "Look, you're supposed to die, but because you did that effort, you give tzedakah, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu protect your life, and the snake that he was supposing to kill you, he was not, instead of killing you, he died." So you see, there is here something that the Goyim cannot understand. Look the difference. Here you have this man who is very famous man, Avlet. He look at the future. When he sees somebody that is going to die, look this man. He saw that he was going to die. So he saw that he's going to die. But he did not see that if he does an effort, if he will do a mitzvah, he will not die. Because the mitzvot, it's not up to Hashem to push you to the mitzvot. Hakol b'di shamayim, chutz mi'at shamayim. When it comes to emunah, when it comes to do mitzvot, when it comes to study Torah, when it comes to do an effort to do a mitzvah, that is not up to Hashem, that it's up to you. A man can change his history. A man can change all his... If there is a gzera on him, the b'shamayim, through the effort that the man he can do, he will change it. Now, I would like just to tell you this. Why the Torah talk too much about those kind of numbers? The Torah is, it's so large. How many the same parasha, each shevet the way they did the inauguration of the Beit HaMikdash. Repetition. 12 times repetition. And the same sacrifice. And the contact of the Jews, of the 12 tribute. The Shabbos, Parashat Bamidbar. I was reading the Torah. I was reading all the calculations of the each Shevet. For me, it doesn't matter to me. I mean, the Torah should say there were X. There is 600,000 Jews. That's it. Why the Torah should try too much? The answer is, HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants you to understand something.
Yes.
That when a Jew studied Torah, his name is written in the Torah. When a Jew studied Torah, look this big Mesirut Nefesh that the Jews did in the desert. In the desert, for 40 years in the desert. Can you imagine? 40 years, no business, 40 years, nothing. Just sitting and studying Torah. They did not even cook. Hashem didn't want them to cook. So they will not need to ask the wife, "I want you to prepare me couscous. I want you to prepare me gefilte fish. I want you to prepare me this and this. No, because whatever they wanted to test in the man, they had it in the man. Even to the toilet, they did not go to the toilet. So they will not waste time at the toilet. They will not waste time in business. They will not waste time on. They were all full time studying Torah. Even Bilam HaRasha, he said, Ma tovu alecha Yaakov. You're super. I never saw something like that. Yaakov, I mean, when he saw the Jews, the way they were all day long, they were studying Torah. He couldn't understand. I mean, it was amazing to see all those thousands of Jews, millions of Jews in the desert sitting and learning Torah.
Yes.
Now, Hashem, he gives the value. It's like it's what the Chafetz Chaim said. The Chafetz Chaim said that why Hashem give us the mitzvah of talit.
Of talit.
Yes, the talit it represents the whole Torah. Like we said, etem oto uzchartem et kol mitzvot Hashem va'atzitem otam. When you look at the talis, when you look at your talis, you will remember that Hashem give you the Torah. So you will do the Torah. The Chafetz Chaim said that the talit it's like a medal. It's a medal. It's a medal. Hashem, Hashem will give you a medal. It's like a decoration. It's like when the king gives you a decoration. I was thinking, what it is a decoration? A decoration is something that you, it's something on gold, on diamond. Something material. If the king give you this, decoration. A few weeks ago, somebody came to see me, and he showed me a decoration that the king of Morocco gave him.
Yeah.
So it was proud. It was very, 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 very proud. So it's the same with Hashem. Hashem is so proud of us. So not only he put our name, he give us the value that we need. What kind of value Hashem gave us, that he said to Moshe Rabbeinu, to count us, to count each family, to count each tribute, and to put the numbers, and the name of the family, and etc., 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 even the sacrifice for the inauguration of the Mishkan, Hashem, he wrote in the Torah each tribute, even that the sacrifice that he did, that they did, it was the same sacrifice, but Hashem, he wanted to give us a value, that our names, our story, what we did, it should be written in the Torah. You understand?
Yes.
I mean, you become in the history, in the eyes of Hashem, when you respect Torah and mitzvot. I mean, you should know that. Once you respect Torah and mitzvot, Hashem can change everything for you. He can change all the nature will change it for you. There is a story about my grandfather, Rabbi Chaim Pinto. It's a fabulous story. It's a terrible story that I heard.
Okay.
This week. A woman came to see me, and she told me, "Thank you, Rabbi David. Here is the two Mexican dollars that you gave me 7 years ago. You told me to give you back the $2 when I will have a baby." That woman, she couldn't have children. The doctors told her husband is sterilized. And she came for a bracha. And she was crying. And I told her, "Madam, you're a young woman. HaKadosh Baruch Hu can change things for you. I want you just to keep Torah mitzvot, keep Nida, keep Shabbat. I just came from Mexico. I give you these two Mexican dollars take them with you. Be'ezat Hashem, the day you have a baby, give me back the dollars. I mean, she took the $2 with a big smile. She told me, what about if I will not come to see you? I told her, Be'ezat Hashem, one day will come. Because I have emunah on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If you have emunah and you change your way of life, Hashem, He will change all the gezerot on you. If in the Shamayim you have no children, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give you children. Be'ezat Hashem, you must have emunah and change your comportment. Change. All what I can tell you is this week I was sitting and she came smiling and she opened the bag and she gave me the $2, the Mexican dollar. They were quite old. And with the paper, the bracha that I wrote to her, both of them, she said, thank you, Rabbi David. Thank you, Hashem. Baruch Hashem, I have a baby. But more than all this is that I keep Shabbat, I keep Nida. And for seven years, I did not ask questions. As you told me, I will not come to see you for 7 years. You say, I did not come to see you for 7 years. With emunah every day, I pray to Hashem. The doctors, they don't believe how my husband, his sperm, today is good. No one understand. No one understand. So I told her, thank you very much. I made a photocopy of the $2, and the paper that I wrote her, and I give her back the $2. I told her, Be'ezat Hashem, Hashem will give you one baby, now I want another one. Be'ezat Hashem, you will come to see me again with another baby. And take this $2, keep them you. This is the emunah. When you have emunah on HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when you put effort, because can you imagine, the doctors tell you are sterilized, you can have children. You believe that you will have children. You pray to Hashem to have children. This is above nature, you understand?
Yes.
This is Mema'al Teva. This is above nature. When you do that, when you act like this, of course HaKadosh Baruch Hu will help you. That way Hashem, He give us a matana. He gave us a gift. What the gift that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave us? That the names of the Jews, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, count the Jews, count each tribute, count each family of each tribute, and write their names, and write the numbers, and write the total. All this big parasha. Why? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it's very important for Him. When we give Him kavod, when we put effort to not to do avera, not to do sins, we put effort to respect Hashem. So of course, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the effort He does, instead of writing mitzvot in His Torah, He writes our names in the Torah. It's unbelievable.
Yes.
It's unbelievable. Now the question is, why the name of woman? Why Hashem did not count the woman? The answer is this. Because the woman, they are not obligated to study Torah. And because they are not obligated to study Torah, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, anyway, the women are partners with the husbands. They are partners with the Torah of the husband. All what I want from the woman is to push the husband to go to study Torah.
Yes.
Push the husband. The Gemara said, when Mashiach will come, there will be tichet amitim. Or the dead person, they will come alive. But only those who study Torah. Those who study Torah, they will have tichet amitim. So the Gemara asks a question, what about the woman? So we will see only men, the resurrection of only men, what about women? The woman, they will not tichet amitim. What about my mother? What about my grandmother? What about all the women? Sarah Imenu, Rivka Imenu. The Gemara answered, yes, they will have the title to come as well to Tichat HaMitim. They will come to a life. Why? With the merit of the education that they give to their children.
Yes.
with the merit of pushing the husband to go to study Torah. And because sometimes the woman, she waits to have her lunch or her dinner at night because her husband is in this, he's in the yeshiva. She's waiting for him. There's a lot of women that they wait for the husband to scream at them, why you came late? But this woman, they knows that sometimes when the husband is in the yeshiva, he's dafayumi, sometimes people talk to him, sometimes he will have 15 minutes more, and the woman with patience, she waits for him. And when he come, she receives him with a big smile. With this zechut, they will have the zechut for the reincarnation when Mashiach will come. So you see here,
resurrection.
Yes, you know the story of Abelazar ben Dodaria. There is a beautiful story of Abelazar ben Dodaria. This man, he was a big rasha. And he was always going out with a woman, always used to pay with prostitutes, always used to pay a lot of money to go out with a nice prostitute, beautiful prostitute. And one day he met a beautiful one, and he paid a lot of money, and he had to cross six rivers. And he went to that woman, and when he entered, he had an appointment with her. When I entered, and when he started to do Avera with her, she had a bad breath, you know, bad. So he told her, "Oh, you see, the smell is not good." She told him, that smile, when he come out, he cannot go back from where he come out. So she told him, "You, Rebel Azab ben Dodaria, from where you came, from where your neshama came, you will not come back, you will not go back there. You have no Olam Haba." And he was shocked. And he went out. And he started to pray. And he started to pray, he said, sky, earth, water, pray for me, that Hashem will accept my teshuva. I'm afraid. And he had a feeling that he was talking by himself. And then he said, "El hadabatalo elavi, only this matter of teshuva, it's not that that they have to pray for me, I have to pray for myself." So he started to pray for himself.
Yes.
And when he started to pray for himself, he started to cry, "Hashem, please forgive me all the avot I did." And he died. And a voice from the Shamayim came, and she said, "Rabbi Azar ben Dodaria, you have helek le'olam haba." Rabbeinu HaKadosh, the one who wrote Mishnayot, he heard the bad call. He heard this voice from the Shamayim, and he started crying. He said, "Oh, yesh kone olamo b'sha'a achad." There is people who can be the biggest Rishaim in the world, and 1 hour, when they do Teshuvah, they can have Olam Haba. There is people all their life, they serve Hashem all their life, 24 hours, to have Olam Haba, to have the zikhut to have Olam Haba. And this man, he had Olam Haba in 1 minute.
Yes.
He was crying, Rabbeinu HaKadosh. Yesh konei olamo be'olam be'yashah. Now, I would like to ask you one question.
Yes.
Have you heard a prostitute giving musar to somebody? I mean, a prostitute. She wants to make money. She don't want to lose customer. I mean, can you imagine a prostitute to do a bad breath, to have a bad breath, I mean, to not to prepare yourself well, and to tell him, to give him Musa, that you have no Olam Haba. I mean, and then, I do not understand why Abel Azab ibn Adariah, why he did not pray for himself at the beginning, why he asked from the sky, for the Shamaim, earth, water, sea, to pray for him. Why did not pray for himself? I mean, it's not logical that I will ask animals to pray for me. I mean, it's not logical that I will ask the Shammai to pray for me. And I did not understand why Rabbi Noah Kadosh, when he heard this, he cried. I don't know. That's a, but one thing I would like to tell you.
Yes.
This is very important, what I want to tell you.
Yes.
We know that our life, it's limited. I mean, you can live 120 years. So, after that's it. Your life could be limited at 120 years. Today they said that people today, they may live longer than before. Because today I believe them. Because today we see more people to living more years. But not all the bodies are the same. If there is a gzera on somebody to die at the age of 48, you know, last week, somebody came to see me. He was very, very healthy. His name is Alain Azon. Not last week, a few years ago. Alain Azon. He's very, very, very wealthy. And he called me one day. He does sport. He's somebody that is... 10 minutes after his wife, she called me. She was crying. Her husband died.
Okay.
10 minutes. He's a sportman, very healthy man. He watched his weight, and he was to the doctor, cardiologist, everything, bam, everything good. Suddenly, bomb, a bomb. No one has a guarantee for his life. Of course, ushmatem me'od l'nafshotechem. We have to take care about our health. If we don't take care about our health, it's no good. But if there is a gzera b'shamayim on somebody, even you take care or you don't take care, this is there's nothing you can do. A man should know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, according to his life, HaKadosh Baruch Hu give him the Torah to study and what he should bring with him after 120 years. You understand that?
Yes.
The same way you want to make money, the same way that you are very upset if you don't make money, a man always should be upset when he don't study enough Torah, when he don't do enough mitzvot. But still, the same way that you want to have success in your material life, you should have the same thoughts and the spiritual life. And the same way that you put effort in your material life, your way of life, you should do it as well in the spiritual life. When you do that, so you have value in the eyes of your body. Has a big value in the eyes of Hashem. Now you understand. Now we understand. This woman, she's a prostitute. She did not understand was she saw a man that he crossed 6 rivers just for a minute, spending so much time to travel from Israel to her and to cross a river, it's a sacrifice. Maybe you will drown the river. Crossing a sacrifice just for a minute, just to have a relationship with a woman. Understand me?
Yes.
This woman, she knows that this man who came to see her is a Jew. She could see through his face that he has a Jewish face. But he loved women. He loved women. Unfortunately. And she saw the sacrifice that he did. She told him, look, you are a Jew. Suppose maybe she was Jewish too, who knows? Maybe that lady, she was Jewish, and she saw a Jewish man doing, putting himself in a big, big troubles, crossing six rivers, just to have a relationship with a woman. 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 7 minutes, waste, I mean, come from far away. How many days, how many months that man was traveling, just for a pleasure of 5 minutes. So she told him, look, I don't think that you do this, the effort for a woman, and you don't do effort for Hashem. You understand?
Yes.
Did you understand the answer or not?
Yes.
I mean, you know, Bemet, I'm telling you, most of the journalists, the newspapers, most of the politics, they don't understand this minister, what he did last week. I mean, how he did that?
Yeah.
You understand this? Tell me.
No.
No one understand how he did that. How? Even children. How? He was on top of the world. How, what happened? What happened to him? Exactly. You don't need to be clever to say those words. That's what this woman said to Elazar ben Adaria. How you come down from up the hill, you sacrifice yourself for this, for 5 minutes, pleasure 5 minutes, how? But, he could carry on doing what he started to do with her. But he stopped. He understood sometimes words that came from the bottom of the heart of somebody can
make an impression.
Can make an impression of the one who hears them. And that's what happened to Elazar ben Adaria. And he went out and he asked if he thought, maybe I'm not enough. I don't have enough zichut, enough merit to pray direct to Hashem. I will ask from the Shamaim to pray for me. And that's what he was thinking. And he felt, no. Once that a man starts to think about praying, so I understood that to pray, you need to people to pray for you. You have to pray for yourself. A lot of people, they came to me, to ask Hashem for forgiveness for them. You know what I tell them?
Yeah.
Why I have to ask Hashem for you? Ask you to Hashem. Why I have to ask to Hashem for you? You can ask Hashem for yourself. Do teshuvah. The teshuvah, it's not up to me. It's not who's going to pray for you. I will pray for you that Hashem will help you, that your teshuvah will be accepted. But the teshuvah, you should ask for Hashem teshuvah. And that's what he understood, Rabbi Elazar ben Adaria. Rabbi Elazar ben Adaria, he understood that it's not enough that Hashem will forgive him if he will ask others to pray for him. He should pray for himself. En hadabar talui elabi. It's up to me that Hashem will forgive me or not to forgive me. How? If I do an effort. Effort! This is the parasha Bechukotai. Effort, Bamidbar, a second effort. Bamidbar, that it's Bamidbar, it's like a desert. I mean, like a man who feel that he abandoned himself, like in the desert. If you find something, the desert belongs to you. Because in the desert, if somebody lost a diamond desert, you don't know this diamond to who it belongs. So it's yours. So a man should put his body like a desert. He should sacrifice his body for Hashem. Imuna, bitachon on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Effort. Big effort. If you do that, you become valuable in the eyes of Hashem. So Hashem, he count you. And so HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you see people that, Baruch Hashem, they're so close to Hashem, so close to Him. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu give them title. What the title give them? You know what title give them?
What did you give them?
when a man give effort, when a man put effort to study Torah, to do mitzvot, to respect, to go on the Derech Hashem, what does Hashem do for him? Hashem, he wrote his name in the Torah. Zichru Sefer Torah Moshe Avdi. The Sefer, all the Torah, it's on the name of Moshe Rabbeinu. Torah Tziva Lanu Moshe, Morasha Kilat Yaakov. Our heritage for Moshe is the Torah. Why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu, he put all his effort on the Torah. When you put your effort on the Torah become yours. Now you understand, that's why Rabbeinu HaKadosh, when Rabbeinu HaKadosh, he heard this man, that he, after his teshuva, after he understood that it's up to him to do teshuva, and he did a big teshuva and he died, and the voice from the Shamaim came and told him that you have Helek L'Olam Haba, that now you are in the paradise, he cried. Yesh Kone Olamo B'Shah Ahad. Listen to this and I finished. There is, hello?
Yes, I'm here, yes.
There is two kinds of effort.
Yes.
There is an effort of all life. That you put all your life, you put all your effort to serve Hashem.
Yes.
There is another kind of effort that you put all your life on 1 minute. On 1 hour that you do teshuva, you put all your life in that way. That means it's like le parfum concentré. It's like today there is a perfume, and there is perfume concentré perfume. That means that from one small bottle you can have 1,000 bottles of perfume. You mix it with water. You understand?
Yes.
Concentré.
Yes.
There is a teshuva of all life. All life you live with teshuva, and there is a teshuva of 1 hour. But that 1 hour should be that hour. It's an hour that has no. No limits. The Gemara said,
yes.
You should never say about somebody that is Rasha, because he did Teshuvah before he died. When you say a Rasha and he died, you should not call him Rasha, because maybe he did Teshuvah before he died. So how Hashem can accept the Teshuvah of a Rasha 1 minute before he died? I mean, all my life I was respecting Hashem to have a title that I am a tzaddik. And this Rasha, all his life he eat taref, all his life he went with women, he did a lot of avarot all his life. All his life he joined life, and 1 minute before he died, he did a teshuva, and he has Olam Haba like me. How you understand this? How you understand? The answer is the effort. That man, all his life, he was going with women. All his life, he was doing a big avarot. But the last minute, he understood that all what he did, it was wrong. And because he put this effort, because the Yetzer HaRa will not lead, this Rasha thinking that. And this Rasha, 1 minute before he died, he realized that he lived in a wrong way. He did not realize this before. Now he realized. Now he's doing teshuva. So Hashem may accept. Because this minute, he put a lot of effort in that minute. Like this man, that he gave tzedakah. The story that I told you before, Shmuel and Avlet. That he went, and Avlet, he told Shmuel, this man is going to die. This man is going to die. And then, 1 hour left, after, destroy my life. Avlet, he said, it's impossible. He's supposed to die. Let's see why he did not die. And they went, they saw something in his shoulder. They took what he has, the you know, the how do you call this? Le sac?
Yeah, the backpack.
Yeah, the pack. The bag that he had in his shoulder, they open it, they find there a snake that he was dying. It's unbelievable, this. That's something that Avlet couldn't understand. He sees future, but there is something more than future. He sees that this man is going to die, but he don't see utzdaka tatzimi mavet. When you do tzedakah, you are protected from death. That he did not see. That only you, according to the effort that you do in Avodat Hashem, you can change your life. Mime'ala teva. So this is the shiur for today.
Very nice.
And I pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that through the effort that you do, HaKadosh Baruch Hu be'ezat Hashem will help you, will give you bracha b'atzlacha, and I give you a bracha. I pray to Hashem that never you will be a poor man, be'ezat Hashem. Always you will be the one who gives tzedakah. Stay there. God bless you.